Today I am going to discuss about cardiac cycle. Cardiac cycle is defined as pressure and volume changes in the heart chambers and blood vessels between two subsequent cardiac contractions. Means beginning of the one cardiac contraction to the beginning of the next cardiac contraction. Normal duration of cardiac cycle is about 0.8 seconds when we consider heart rate at around 75 beats per minute. Different events of cardiac cycle are mentioned. First one is atrial systole. Normal duration is about 0.1 second. Atrial diastole of about 0.7 second. Ventricular systole of about 0.3 second. And ventricular diastole of 0.5 second.
Different phases of ventricular systole are isovolumetric ventricular contraction and ventricular systole proper. Different phases of ventricular diastole are protodiastole, isovolumetric ventricular relaxation, ventricular diastole proper, and last rapid filling phase due to atrial systole. Let us understand it through diagram. This is the diagram showing the anatomical structure of heart and blood vessels. This is right atrium, this is left atrium, this is right ventricle and this is left ventricle. This is superior and inferior vena cava and this is aorta, which arises from left ventricle. This is pulmonary vein which drain blood to left atrium and this is right ventricle from where pulmonary artery rises. This is the simplified diagram of what I mentioned earlier. Let us start with the atrial systole. When atrial chamber contracts, there will be increase in the atrial pressure. Right atrial pressure rises to about 4 to 6 mmHg and left atrial pressure increases to about 7 to 8 mmHg. When these atrial muscles contract, at that time there will be narrowing of the orifices of the vena cava and pulmonary veins. Because these vessels doesn't contain any valves, narrowing of the orifices will prevent the backflow of the blood when the atrial muscles are contracting. When atrial muscle contract, it will cause movement of the blood from the atria to the ventricle and thus it increases ventricular pressure. Now next phase is ventricular systole. First phase is isovolumetric ventricular contraction. As the atrial contraction passes off, atrial pressure start reducing and ventricles are invaded by the process of excitation. As ventricular contraction begins, there will be increase in the ventricular pressure. When ventricular pressure exceeds the pressure of the atrium, it will cause closure of these AV valves. Closure of the AV valves will produce first heart sound. Now ventricles are behaving like a closed chamber because AV valves are closed and semilunar valves are not opened yet. So in this phase, although ventricle is contracting, but it is behaving like a closed chamber, so there is no emptying of the blood, means volume remains same, thus called as isovolumetric ventricular contraction. When the ventricles are contracting, at that time there may be bulging of these AV valves into the atria, which may cause little rise in atrial pressure. The next phase of ventricular systole is ventricular systole proper. When right ventricular pressure exceeds the pressure of the pulmonary artery, which is about 10 to 12 mmHg, and left ventricular pressure exceeds the pressure of aorta, which is about 80 mmHg, there will be opening of the semilunar valves. Thus, it will cause movement of the blood from the ventricles into the arteries. Initially, there is a rapid ejection of the blood, which is about 2/3 of the stroke volume. Pressure also increases at that time because of the entry of the blood into the pulmonary artery and aorta. Rapid ejection is followed by slow ejection phase because ventricular contraction begins to subside with slow ejection of blood into the pulmonary artery and aorta. The amount of blood ejected by each ventricle per stroke at rest during this phase is known as stroke volume, which is about 70 to 80 ml. After the ventricular contraction process is over, some amount of blood will be still left into the ventricular chamber, that is known as end systolic volume, which is about 50 ml. Then next phase is ventricular diastole. It has four phases. First one is protodiastole. In this phase, as the ventricular contraction process gets over, ventricle starts relaxing. When the ventricles are relaxing, there will be decrease in the intraventricular pressure. When the pressure of the ventricles becomes less than the pressure of the vessels, that is, right ventricular pressure becomes less than the pressure of the pulmonary artery and left ventricular pressure becomes less than the pressure of the aorta, there will be closure of the semilunar valves. Closure of these valves will produce sinking heart sound. The next phase is isovolumetric ventricular relaxation. It is a phase next to the protodiastole, means here semilunar valves are closed and AV valves are not yet opened. So ventricle is relaxing continuously and it is behaving like a closed chamber. So in spite of continuous relaxation, there will be no change in the volume. So ventricle is behaving like a closed chamber. Thus it is called as isovolumic ventricular relaxation. The next phase of ventricular relaxation is ventricular diastole proper. When the ventricular pressure becomes less than the pressure of the atria, there will be opening of the AV valve and blood will flow from the atria towards the ventricle. During this phase, rapid filling of the ventricle will occur, means 70% of the ventricle will be filled passively just by opening of the AV valve, as atria is also not involved by the process of contraction. This phase is followed by slow filling of the ventricle, which is known as diastasis. In this phase, continuous venous return from the superior and inferior vena cava to the right atrium and from the pulmonary veins to the left atrium reaches to the ventricle. Now, last phase of ventricular diastole is last rapid filling phase. In the last rapid filling phase, now atrium is involved by the process of contraction and atrial systole will cause the movement of the blood about 25% from the right atria to the right ventricle and from the left atria to the left ventricle, and it terminates the cardiac cycle. Now, atrial diastole. As atrial muscles start relaxing, there will be increase in the atrial pressure due to continuous venous return. It decreases when AV valve will open and movement of blood will occur from the atria towards the ventricles and again start rising during the phase of diastasis of ventricular relaxation. Important points to remember. What is ejection fraction? It is the percentage of end diastolic volume that is ejected with each heartbeat. Normally, it is 65% and it is a valuable indicator of ventricular contractility. What is the effect of heart rate on the duration of cardiac cycle? At a normal heart rate of about 75 beats per minute, ventricular diastole is 0.5 seconds. This duration decreases to 0.14 seconds at a heart rate of about 200 beats per minute. The duration of systole is much more fixed. What is end diastolic volume and end systolic volume? Volume of blood in the ventricular chambers at the end of ventricular diastole is called as end diastolic volume. Normal value is about 120 to 140 ml. Volume of blood in the ventricular chambers at the end of ventricular systole is called as end systolic volume. Normal value is about 50 ml. What is the significance of end diastolic volume? End diastolic volume is the preload for cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle obeys Frank-Starling law. So when end diastolic volume increases, it increases the force of contraction and thus increases cardiac output.
Thank you.